What's up, everybody? Welcome to the channel. If you're new here, thanks for being here. If you're a subscriber, thank you for coming back. Not long ago, I put out a sticker giveaway with a QR code in there that you could buy the channel a beer to show your support. I was able to buy the channel 2 new lav mics. So I hope from here on out, the quality of the sound is mucho bueno. So thank you for that. You guys rock, seriously. But today's topic is this little guy. It's a 48 volt razor built for an adult. So we're gonna go over the parts. I'm gonna go over what I did to it, what it's got, the top speed, maybe do a little ride for you guys. So stay tuned. All right, guys, starting at the front of this bike, this is the stock wheels on this bike. I painted the wheels black. You do the old playing card trick, deflate the tires, stick a playing cards inside the rim, paint it. These are fork straws. You cut these to length and you put them on the spokes yourself. Give your bike your individual look. The brake kit is from Ride or Die, R&D. The brakes are Zoom brakes. I got a brake adapter from the Ride or Die R&D guys to make these Zoom brakes work on these pit bike forks. Moving up, the forks themselves are from eBay, and the fork clamps I got from Amazon. You just gotta make sure that they have a 45 and a 48 millimeter taper on the clamps. I'll include links in all this stuff. The headlight was from Amazon. The Zoom brakes, you can get the Zoom brakes from Gerardo at Lone Star Electric, or you can get those on Amazon. Good thing about Gerardo's are they're already wired for your left hand to be your rear brake. So that's good for pit bikes if you like to do wheelies. If you don't, it doesn't really matter. Moving up here, the handlebars are pit bike handlebars. The risers came with the triple trees. The grips from Amazon. This voltmeter throttle you can get from Amazon. Now when you order the Vevor kit from Vevor, it comes with a throttle, comes with the motor, and it comes with the controller. But what you get is the throttle that has the three bars or the four bars, right? High, medium, low on your voltage. So whenever I build a bike, especially for an adult, I want to put a voltmeter on there so that you have an exact idea of what the voltage is. On a 48 volt battery, totally full on your charge, is 54 volts. So when you check your voltmeter, you see 54 volts, you're good to go. Moving on here, the graphics I got from eBay. eBay is a really good source for graphics, all kinds of colors and themes that you like. On this particular one, I painted the motor covers. I like the way that looks. It just looks clean. It looks intentional. It pops. You know, it just shows that you took a little bit extra time to build these bikes up. The, of course, you got the Ride or Die ATX sticker on there. The seat is a tall seat. It's for a CRF50. There is some modification that has to be done on the seat pan in order to make this fit this frame. No big deal if you got a little grinder or a Dremel, easy to do. This one, I relocated the charger. So this is where it charges. And these switches here are running my lights. So this switch here is not running anything at the moment, but I left it open in case I wanna put something to it later down the road. This switch here runs my headlight, my taillight, and this switch here runs my LEDs. So I got LEDs that I can control from my phone. There's an LED strip under here on both sides of the swing arm. And then there's also an LED strip that runs up the front of the bike right here. So at night, this thing is gonna shine, man. This is gonna get some attention. That's what I like, flashy. The shock is a D&M 200 millimeter shock. Been running these shocks on all my bikes for a long time. It's perfect for the street for my weight. I'm about 190 pounds. Motor is the Vevor motor. If you wanna know how to put the Vevor motor in, check out the video library. I got a video with Jacob Youngblood from Ride or Die R&D. We go over how to install the motor, the wiring, the controller, the throttle, all the things. The chain is a 25H chain. I had to cut it to length because I didn't wanna run the stock gear. This is a 55 tooth rear, it's 25H chain. But if you run the stock chain with a Vevor motor controller set, the thing just wants to wheelie out from under you. It's almost uncontrollable. And I like to think of this bike as the golf cart of pit bikes. It's not super fast, but it's got good range. Not super torquey, it's just right. Smooth, it's deliverable, it's manageable. It'll get you around the neighborhood It'll get you to the bars. It'll get you to your buddy's house. It's a 20 amp hour battery. You're probably gonna get 10 to 15 miles on it, depending on your weight, the battery temperature, the terrain you're riding in, and how much you weigh. There's also, too, how you manage the throttle. Are you on it all the time? Are you just coasting? All these things make a difference when it comes to battery and how long they last. This taillight is from Ride or Die R&D. You can get this taillight on their website. It's a brake light. So if you have a brake switch, you can run that light into your switches and it'll act as a brake light, or you can just wire it as a running light. It's up to you. These particular brakes do not have the ability to wire into the brake. So this is just going to be a running light so I don't get hit from behind from one of my bros, you know, on one of our group rides. All right, so the walkthrough is over. If you have any questions about the parts, leave them in the comments. I answer all the comments. I'll have links in the description for you. But what do you say we get this thing on the road and we take it for a ride? All right, guys, so that's it for this one. Thank you for being here. Thank you for spending your time with me. I appreciate your time. I know you could be doing a thousand other things, but being here with me right now, spending your time on this channel, much appreciated. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed the content. If you did, make sure you like it. Hit the subscribe button. Do the social media thing. And if you thought, well, this guy didn't suck and you want to support the channel, there's a link in the description where you can buy the channel a beer, whatever you can afford, and it goes back to the channel, just like the mics, cameras, action, you know, this stuff. Have a great weekend, y'all. Bye.